A disease across a large area, spanning multiple continents, a worldwide disaster affecting a global population is called a pandemic. Throughout history, many pandemics such as smallpox, influenza, and the plague have occurred. The consequences of a pandemic can significantly change the world and affect its population. One of the most devastating pandemics was the Black Death from 1331 to 1353, which killed an estimated 75 to 200 million people and wiped out nearly half of Europe's population. But how did we survive, and how were pandemics actually stopped? As humanity progressed, so did the outbreaks of infectious diseases across international borders. Urbanization, globalization, larger cities, frequent travel, and trade led to an easier disease transmission and increased its spread dramatically. The disease spread rate is affected by different factors. A basic measure for tracking infectiousness of a disease is called the reproduction number, also known as R0. This number indicates how contagious an infectious disease is. It tells us the average number of people who are affected by one contagious person. For example, an R0 of untreated tuberculosis is 10, meaning a single person can infect on average 10 people in an unvaccinated population. So just imagine how this chain of infection can progress from one person to the next. When a viral outbreak happens, the number of patients begins to grow exponentially. The virus quickly spreads to the population, and the number of new cases goes up suddenly. In a brief period, the curve reaches a peak. As the number of infected people continue to rise, the capacity of the healthcare system decreases. As a result, hospitals are overwhelmed, medical assistance cannot be provided to a large number of patients at the same time, leading to a lower chance of survival and obviously more deaths. So a key part of controlling a viral outbreak is to decrease the curve trend, known as flattening the curve, which aids in slowing down the virus spread and, as a result, helps in preventing health services overload. Also, it buys time for better treatment and for a vaccine to be developed. Now, strategies for putting this into action include strict measures that must be undertaken in the early stages of a pandemic, especially if it is a novel pathogen and necessary antiviral agents, antibiotics, and vaccines have not yet been developed. In the alternate scenario, if left untreated, the pandemic would end faster, but depending on the illness, a lot more people would die in a short period of time. Non-pharmaceutical preventative measures such as personal hygiene, washing our hands regularly, avoiding touching your mouth, nose, eyes, travel restrictions, self-quarantine, and social distancing, closing schools and canceling mass gatherings are of great importance during a pandemic outbreak. Social distancing measures flatten out the epidemic curve, stop the disease from spreading to the rest of the population, and reduce the overall number of cases. The outbreak is brought under control when there are no more cases reported or herd immunity has been acquired. When some people become immune, they can stop the disease spread and therefore protect others in the population, which is also called herd immunity. In simple terms, after recovering from an illness, we become immune, meaning that the immune system has remembered previous exposure and can now react much faster and act effectively in combating reinfection and preventing the disease. This also very simply illustrates a principle by which vaccines work. However, the problem arises when a pandemic is caused by a novel virus that we have not yet encountered, for which there is no appropriate medicine or vaccine. Vaccine development is a slow and complex process which requires strict testing and regulations. Moreover, viruses tend to change and mutate rapidly, transforming into a more potent form and therefore triggering the second wave of virus spread, which delays the vaccine development even more. So, taking all of this into account, the only way we can slow down the disease spread and prevent further infections is to respond immediately and effectively in the early stages of a pandemic. Each one of us can contribute to the limiting of the infection spread by acting according to the implemented measures. Self-quarantine significantly reduces the number of infected people. Early action will save lives, so be responsible and stay at home. Thank you for watching. Check out why the Spanish flu was so deadly by clicking on the screen, and also check out our Instagram for daily facts. See you next time.